The reconciliation measure includes tougher insurance reforms, major changes in the student loan program, and closes a gap in the Medicare prescription drug coverage over the next decade. And Cynthia, today you were out talking with Central Iowans about this health care overhaul.
Talked to a lot of folks all around town. A CBS News poll found 54% of Americans are confused about the plan, and we found that to be the case here.
Dennis Wolfkeith had a career as a counselor, but since losing his job, he's lost his insurance.
I've found myself, out of necessity, having to come to County Hospital.
Glad to see the government will provide tax breaks for those who can't afford health insurance and expand Medicaid to millions more.
It's about time. It didn't go far enough, but we have to start somewhere.
I think it's the greatest thing that's happened since Social Security. We're going to insure. How many? 34 million more people are going to be able to afford insurance. It's a private plan. It's not government owned.
But many don't want the government involved.
I think some of the abortion concerns know that they're going to be paying for abortions with government funds. It's probably my principal concerns.
Most like the fact that insurers won't be able to deny coverage if you're sick, but some fear losing free coverage.
They'll say, well, you can go into the government health plan. So that could be a double-edged sword right there. We just have to keep faith in our union.
This 94-year-old says the whole health care system makes her ill.
I'm sick about it. That's all I know, because I'm paying too much money for my medicine. Pills. $70 for a little pill that's as big as my nail.
And you think this might help?
I don't know.
I really didn't think it was going to happen, so I didn't research it enough, and I didn't get active enough in it. I don't think I want it, but I'm not sure.
And we'll just see in time whether this was the right way to go or not.